Quadratic formula, using the formula. So I'm going to teach you guys about this equation called the quadratic formula. And basically it says that if ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0, then we can find x by saying x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. So the idea here is that if we took the coefficient, the number in front of each of my terms, or the number that just is the last term, that term that's just a number, then we could plug that in to this equation as a and b and c, and we could solve for x. So this equation is going to be one that we're going to have to use lots, and so I feel like it's a really good one for you guys to memorize. And I know that 12 years ago, when I first learned this equation, I had it sung to me, and it helped me memorize it a lot. So I'm going to sing for you. So here we have the quadratic formula. X equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. We all know the quadratic formula, quadratic formula, quadratic formula. So you guys don't have to sing the song, but I feel like it can be very helpful for memorizing this equation since you will be using it a lot. So, there you have it. Let's go ahead and take a look at an example where we actually figure out how to use this formula in order to find out what x is. So our example one right here is 6x squared plus 7x minus 3 equals 0. So first we need to figure out what our coefficients are. So we've got 6 right here, that'll be our a. Got a 7 right here, that'll be our b. And right here I've got a negative 3, so c is going to be negative 3. So now we want to go ahead and plug each of these into our formula. So we're going to have negative b, negative 7, plus or minus the square root of 7 squared minus 4 times a is going to be 6, c is going to be negative 3, watch your negative signs, really careful with your negatives, all over 2 times a, and a is 6. Okay, so then all that we have to do is simplify this expression. So when we go to simplify, we're going to have negative 7 plus or minus the square root, 7 squared, or 7 times 7 is 49. Okay, and then we've got minus 4 times 6 is 24 times 3. That I really don't know right off the top of my head, so I'm just going to go ahead and write it over here in the margin. So 3 times 4 will give me 12. 3 times 2 give me 6, plus 1 is 7. Ooh, 72. Not too bad. Okay, and then I've got over 2a, so that'll be 12. Okay, so now I want to do 49 plus 72 for the next step of simplifying. Which I gotta say is another thing I don't know right off the top of my head. So again, sometimes it's just good to have a side note so you can keep track of everything. 2 plus 9 is 11, and then 1 plus 7 is 8, plus 4 is 12. Okay, so now I know that this expression is equal to negative 7 plus or minus the square root of 121 divided by 12. So this 121, I am recognizing that number. That is 11 times 11. So I can say that this is plus or minus the square root of 11 squared divided by 12. And remember from earlier in this unit when we were simplifying radicals, we've got the square root has a little implied 2 right here. So this radical square root, you know, is going to undo this exponent, this squared exponent. So then we'll just end up with negative 7 plus or minus 11, oops, divided by 12. So now we have this plus or minus, and that means that there's actually going to be two different solutions, which is kind of what we've been seeing. A lot of our equations where we've got an x squared end up with two different solutions. So we're going to have two different solutions here, and one of them is going to be negative 7 plus 11 divided by 12, and the other one is going to be negative 7 minus 11 divided by 12. So this left-hand side right here, negative 7 plus 11 will give me 4 divided by 12. Top and bottom here are both divisible by 4, so we can reduce this fraction to 1/3. And then over here I've got negative 7 minus 11 is going to give me minus 18 divided by 12. These are both divisible by 6. So 18 divided by 6 will give me negative 3. 12 divided by 6 will give me 2. Okay, so the beginning of this equation really was x equals this entire mess. So that means that what we come up with down here are two different possible values for x. So our solution is going to be x equals 1/3 or negative 3/2. Okay, so now we're going to scroll down and work on example 2. So for example 2, I've got some coefficients like this. A is going to be negative 5, and then when I come to my b, I don't really have a number in front of this x, so you have to be careful here. Remember that there's an invisible 1, so our b is going to be negative 1, and then our c is going to be 2. Okay, so now we're going to go ahead and plug these into the formula. And since we scrolled down, it would be really helpful if we had this formula memorized. So here we go. X equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. Okay, beautiful. So now we can go ahead and plug in our numbers. So we're going to have x equals, so we start out with this negative b, so we'll have like negative of negative 1. And then we'll have plus or minus the square root of b squared. We'll have this negative 1 squared minus 4 times negative 5 times c is 2 all over 2 times a, and a is negative 5. Okay, so let's do some simplifying. So on top here, minus and negative, that will just become positive 1, plus or minus square root of negative 1 times negative 1 is 1, and then multiply these all together. Negative 4 times 5 will give us 20, and then times 2 will give us 40, and the negative times a negative right here, we're going to have a positive. All over 2 times negative 5 is negative 10. Okay, so now I can still combine those numbers inside the radical, square root of 41 over negative 10. So I can definitely see right now that this 41 isn't going to be a perfect square, but I might still be able to simplify this radical sum using prime factorization. So let's go ahead and look at 41, try to break that down. Well, actually, 41 is a prime number, so I'm not going to be able to break it down at all. So there's not going to be any way to simplify this radical any farther, and x equals this fabulous mess is going to be our final answer. So when you're working with the quadratic formula, it won't be that rare for you to actually have a plus or minus sign show up in your final answer.